Good morning. And thank you very much, Maharshi, like, for this opportunity to demonstrate our healthcare application to all the team members. And as Tushar bhai said, like, you know, I hope everyone is safe at their home. So first, we are going to, like, it's a, just a sheer coincidence, we can say, like, you know, we are discussing healthcare applications during this pandemic situation. So first, we will discuss about Medify healthcare application. Tushar bhai, please switch to next slide, please. Next, So like, I'm just run you through a quick agenda of this particular demonstration session. So like, first we will discuss about our client, Medify Healthcare. Then we will, I will give you a brief about functional specification of this particular project. Then we will discuss about technological stack. Then we will have a demo of mobile application with three user interface. And then we will talk about our team members. And also we talk about phase two requirements. Next slide, please. Yes. So, like, our client is Medify Nexus LLP. So, this client is, like, you know, strong medical background. He's from family where all the people are, you know, well known doctors and from healthcare background. And his thought is, like, you know, to have a strong ecosystem. When we talk about healthcare ecosystem, so it comes, like, it combines doctor, patient, pharmacy, hospitals or labs. So initial thought, like, you know, when client, like we started in early December when client approached us. Okay, so initially the thought was, like, client thought was, like, you know, he was having one more website and he wants to upgrade that particular website. And he was earlier he was working with another vendor, but he was not satisfied with that particular vendor, and he approached Brainwire. And then we had a couple of sessions where we discussed, like, we brainstormed his requirement. Also he met Chintan sir also, and we convey him, like, our work style, our expertise. So somehow he got convinced. And then later stage, like, when we started requirement gathering and brainstorming, so, like, he concluded, like, you know, instead of going for website, we will continue with mobile applications. Like, it was our thought, like, you know, nowadays most of the user base is using mobile applications. So he was also pretty convinced, and he come up with thought, like, you know, we will have mobile applications. So this mobile application combine three user roles, like patients, doctor and pharmacist. And we have developed iOS and Android application for this particular client. So key features, like, you know, on this application, you will get all the verified profiles of doctors and pharmacies. Then e-prescription is there. Using those e-prescription, you can order your medicines. So these are some key features, you can say, of this particular application. Yeah, so talking about functional specification, as I mentioned, there are three user roles, key three user roles, like patient, pharmacy, and doctors. And we have web-based admin. So talking about all three users, like, key functionalities, like, you know, they can register themselves and they can manage their own profiles. Then the beauty of this application is, like, you know, it's works on connection. Like, for example, if there is one patient and one doctor, so for communicating with each other, they need to connect first. And it's a patient-centric application. Like, patient needs to connect to the doctor. If patient is connected with doctor, then and only doctor will able to prescribe medicines to that particular patient. Same thing, like, you know, if a patient is connected with pharmacy, then pharmacy can view orders, like whatever orders received from the patient, and they can approve or reject it. Third thing is, like, you know, consultation in medical history. So patient can add own medical history, medical reports, their blood reports, any kind of reports they can add, and they can have database for own reference also, and it will help doctors also to understand more about their medical history. Consultation is nothing but prescription. So whenever this particular patient will visit doctors or whatever prescription will be there, it will become under consultations. Also, these applications have medical inventory, medicines inventory. So like from backend, we have provided some sort of medicines, and pharmacies can view those medicines, and they can maintain their own inventory also, like based on availability, like it's available or not available. And similarly, doctors while prescribing and patients also while ordering, they can have a quick glance like whether this medicine is available or not available. Also, they can view like is there any offers or discount on this particular medicine. Order is another functionality, like where using e-prescription, patient can order and pharmacist can view those orders, and like it's their call, like whether they want to accept or reject that particular order. Also, there is one more functionality like reviews. So patient, pharmacy or doctors can give reviews to each other based on their experience. And messaging. So talking about messaging, for example, if a patient has ordered some medicines, so just to cross-check, pharmacy can communicate with doctor also, or to just make sure pharmacy can communicate with patient also. Or so vice versa, like patient also can communicate with doctors or pharmacies. So such kind of messaging we have provided. Talking about backend side, we have user management, then KYC management. Since it's a medical app and we are handling critical data like personal data and healthcare data also, so only connected members will have access to each other data. Like talking about patient medical history, so only connected doctors will be able to view patient's medical history or prescriptions. Talking about pharmacists can only view order and patient profile, but not related to medical history. So whenever any pharmacy or doctor is onboarding on this application, so they need to provide some KYC document, like some documents for KYC purpose. And once this KYC is get approved, then and then only they will get access of this application. Also, we have a dashboard where we have some indicators which will provide all the information at one glance for admin. Then from backend, like we are handling medicine inventory, then symptoms management, specialization management. So symptoms management is nothing but like while prescribing, we have make easy to the doctors, like they can easily select symptoms, just like medicines. Like medicines also, like they need to just start typing, and based on that they will get some suggestion, and from the suggestion list they can add medicines. Also, we have roles and permissions, it was client request, he want to give access to like their sub admin. He wants to have some sub admin roles, who can manage those different modules. So we have provided roles and permission module. Then timely notification and alerts are there, push notifications, email and SMS. Okay. Talking about integrations, we have Google Map, which will provide information like nearby doctor, nearby pharmacies. Also, for communication, earlier client thought was to have PubNub, then we switched to QuickBlocks, but some reason client have some other thoughts in mind for future development. So we skip those things, and currently we have WhatsApp integration for communication purpose. So this is all about functional overview. Over to you, Tushar Bhai. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Shashank. It was great overview. So for the technical overview, this is some patient, one of us in the world, anyone have some issue, then medical issue, then we require to connect the doctor first. So in this application, as a patient, if I have signed up, then I can search the doctor with their name or their designation, MD, MD gynec, MD physician, anything I search, and I can connect that doctor. and check his details that which time his clinic is opening, how much waiting times are over there, how much fees they are doing, how they are coordinating with the payment and everything. They can connect, or also they can check the their review as well. Same for the pharmacy. Yeah, in this we have iOS with the Swift, Android with Kotlin, and backend side we have Angular, Admin, MySQL, MongoDB we have used, and API we have used Lumen, and AWS server we have. For the mobile application, first we will check for the patient, where patient can sign up with the their details. Then they have they need to provide that some personal detail, that how much weight they have, how much blood pressure they are. So if doctor want to check that by the communicating, that they can check that. So for this detail we have Mr. Akash Moradia, and he will demonstrate you live demonstrate with the mobile application. Yeah, Akash, over to you.
Yes, thank you Tushar sir.
Yeah
Can just you run a demo?
Yeah Can anyone see my screen? Still it shows the seats, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Just a moment. Yeah.
Yes, it's visible.
Yeah. Okay, fine. First login. The first screen. Yes. After the login, the first screen will show is a medical history. Here you can see a list of a medical history that added by a patient or prescribed by a doctor. And you can also see a plus button at the top right of the corner that is used to add a medical history. Here you can see a title, symptoms, referring doctor, and add a note. Title is a medical history title, right? Like a back pain or a fever, cold, something like that. And symptoms, symptom is the yes, fever, cold, it can be pain, something is a predefined list. You can select from that list, and the you can also mention a referring doctor name and also add a note. And there is a yes. There is also upload document option where you can upload your prescribed medicines. Yes. And then confirm. It will upload your medical history. Yes. You can also see a filter icon at the top that is used to this is the list of symptoms. You can filter your medical history by these symptoms. It can be multiple selected. Please select some symptoms and filter. Yes. Right. Okay. Fine. Then please go to the filter screen and reset. Yes, fine. You can also see a switch button in each entry that is used to hide your medical history from your connected doctor. This entry will be hide from the doctor that you have connected. Okay, let's move to the doctor screen. Yes. This screen will display a list of doctors along with their specialty, qualifications, and number of consultations given on Medify system, and number of patients connected to that doctor, right? You can also see a filter icon at top right corner that is used. Please go to the filter screen. This is the list of the specializations. You can choose a multiple specialization and filter according to that specializations. Please select some specialization and filter, sir. Yes, I ask. Okay. Please go to the filter screen and reset. Yes. You can also see a connect button that is used to connect to a specific doctor. And after you connected with the doctor, that doctor can add medical history to your profile, right? Okay. Yes. Yes, now that Misha doctor can add a medical history to your profile. There is also a call and a message icon. That call icon will redirect to your dialer, phone dialer, and the please, yes, you can select anyone. Okay, fine, to cancel. The message icon will redirect to your direct your WhatsApp number. WhatsApp. Yes. Okay. Please cancel. Fine. Okay. Please go to the doctor profiles. Yes. Here you can see personal information and professional information of doctor. Personal information like email, mobile number, alternate phone number, gender, the registration number of the doctor, city of practice, age, and rating. Here you can also please click on view all. You can also see all the rating of the doctor. Please back. Okay, move to the professional. Yes, here you can see a qualification of the doctor, the documents, the registration documents they have uploaded, specialty, further specifications, years of experience, the clinic, which is the primary, then that can be a multiple clinic, but you can see here, Ayurveda is a primary clinic, right? And you can also check the waiting time, services provided, hours of operations. Please click on that hours of operations. Yes, like Monday, Tuesday, which is the time of the open and close, right? Okay, please back to the. Yes, you can see the directions of that particular clinic. Yes. Yeah. Now please move to the pharmacy listing. Yes. yes, this screen will display a list of pharmacies along with the landmark, number of orders fulfilled by the pharmacy, number of doctor connected to the pharmacy. Here also there is a connect button. You can connect with one more or pharmacy by click on the connect button. By connecting to a pharmacy, you can place your order to that particular pharmacy. Here also there is a call and a chat button. Yes, move to the pharmacy detail. Here you can see a personal information of that pharmacy, like some basic details, email, mobile, license number, GST number, deliveries, delivery time, delivery radius. Also, you can see your ratings and the location of that pharmacy. Please move to that bottom. Yeah. You can also see a payment details, like what type of payment provided by the pharmacy, right? And the timing of that pharmacy, like opening and closing time. Now move to the inventory. In inventory, you can see a search field where you can search any type of medicine. And the check the availability of the medicines, right? Yes, that the green sign is indicate you the availability, and also there is a red sign that is indicate unavailability of the medicines, right? Please clear that search. Yes. Okay. Now move to the offer. You can see a list of offer that is provided by the pharmacy. Yes. Now go to the order screen. Yes. This screen will display a list of orders along with that pharmacy name and landmark and status of that order. You can see like a requested, cancel, accepted, a different type of status. And you can also see a bill amount, the dates, like a order process date, like on which date is placed, on which date is delivered on, and which date it accepted, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Please move to the order detail. Yes. Here you can see pharmacy details, like which pharmacy's address, its landmark. You can also see a date of acceptance. Each status dates, like a date of acceptance, requested date, and a doctor name. And medicines you have uploaded during place and order. Also here you can also see your documents which you have uploaded at the time of order, right? Yes, you can see here the documents. Okay, fine. Yes, this is the medicines and order documents, right? These are the details of your order. Okay, fine. Please, you can also view the documents and share to your wherever, like WhatsApp or yes, WhatsApp. Yes, please close that. And here you can also see a cancel button. By click on that cancel button, you can cancel your order, right? There is also another button that is called received. That is used to mark your order as received. When you mark your order as received, there is also one thing will come up like a feedback. You need to add a feedback to that pharmacy, right? Please click on that received icon. Yes, received. Yes, this is the feedback icon where you can provide a specific feedback to a particular pharmacy. Yes, feedback is provided. Yes, now order is completed. Yes, you can see the status completed request. Now, please click on that plus icon at top right of the column. Yes, here you can see select pharmacy option these pharmacies are the list of pharmacies that you are connected with. Yes, these are the your connected pharmacies. Only connected pharmacies will be shown here. Yes, you have select Dev Pharmacy. Now you can add your some notes for that order. Now there is a two options. Either you can select a special prescription, or you can enter your referring doctor name, right? We have both options. Yes, you have selected your MISA doctor. By click on that add medicine, you can add your medicines. Yes, please enter one. Yes. Yes, you can also upload any document like your prescribed document. Yes. Yes, now simply confirm. Now your order will be placed. Okay, now to the vitals. These are the vital informations that you have entered during your profile creation, like it's a temperature, pulse rate, blood pressure, blood group, allergies, injuries. These are the not mandatory fields, but you can enter for your doctor's reference. This information will be shown into your profile. Yes, I think all the functions cleared. Yes, yeah, this is the profile. You can see your details. Medical history will be shown. Your vitals information. Yes. Yeah. This profile will be shown to the doctor when he open your profile on his login, right? Okay, fine. Now I think all the features are covered. Yes.
Yeah, Akash, thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much for it. So very, very helpful things. Now, yeah, patients, we have checked that if I am a patient, I need to check with which is the doctor nearest me, which is his designation, which I can connect with them. I can visit them, get their consultation and connect with pharmacy and order the things. Right, that I can order with my prescription, with my medicines and any other documents I have. So I will log in as a doctor, that I can do any consultation, that which clinic I have. If I am in Ahmedabad, I have 4 clinics, like in Maninagar, in Navarangpura, in NE2, Chandkheda and Ghatlodia area, that which I will select, that which area I have to select. I need to select that patient which I am connected, that right now it's front of me. Then title, that what issue, prescription patient required, like he have some cough. Then I will add that symptoms, that whatever he have, add some notes that required some blood test. And whatever blood test required, doctor can add that medicine on initial stage, that whatever they want to add. Same as Akash has explained, like these medicines for 1 week, dosage one morning and night, that need to take, right? Also can upload the prescription whichever doctor have consulted, then select the take the photo and add the consultation with front of whatever have, right? This is a brief about the consultation that doctor can add consultation with a connected patient and non-connected patient for their information. Like today I have consulted person, but he is not on the Medify, but then also doctor can add that consultation. They can search, they can filter, their doctor can filter their consultation, whatever data we have, then that types of data only we display over here. Like whatever I have, I can apply and get the details. Yeah, doctor can see all the connected patients list in his list, that these are the patient are connected with me and when they have last visited with me, like the first patient have visited last on 7th and second patient also last 7th. These are the patient which are connected with me, but still they require to visit my clinic, right? They can see their details, whatever details they have provided, their medical history and everything in the past. They can search with their name, and the pharmacies are also list of all the pharmacy are nearby pharmacy. Like we have logic that nearby 100 kilometer area only pharmacy would be listed with my current location, and order by connected list. My all the connected pharmacy will become on the top, and then order by all the nearest pharmacy would be display. Same as logic we have, like a call, the message and everything. And the doctor can pharmacy could not connect directly to the doctor and patient, that both patient and doctor need to connect with the pharmacy, then only pharmacy can coordinate with the doctor and patient. same we have review, like patient can add review about the doctor, that this doctor is very good, you can visit if you have such a kind of issue. He is the best doctor in the Ahmedabad area, like you have some back pain and like that. We have good doctors in our some hospital name, like whatever you want to say, that Sola Hospital is a best hospital that you can visit for this type of things. Then you can add review report. If you think that this doctor is not up to you, your expectation, and he is required not giving you proper medicine, whatever you have issue, you can just report that. Same time, admin will get the email and notification with the SMS, and admin will take the such action against the doctor and contact with them. Same, we have a profile. That doctor must have proper profile, that they have, they need to upload their degree, certificates, whatever approval of the your nearby Nagarpalika and everything, your approval certificates, that they need, the admin will review them. Their your license number, doctor license number, city of practice, is your doctor have provided, practice area is proper or not. They will offline review that thing, then only they will allow them to connect with the any patient and pharmacy. Okay, same time, if you add any clinic, any update, your doctor update, any their professional detail, they will same time email will send to the admin. Admin have a few teams members, they have some roles, that if a patient, sorry, doctor have updated anything, they will get the details of the SMS. Admin team will review their document, they can accept, reject, and same time doctor access will be stopped. So these are the things about the doctor, that they can see that how many connection they have, consultation they have done till dates, how many patients are connected with them. They can check that, they can check the notification they are getting, they can review the things. Yeah, let's move to the pharmacy. Pharmacy is like like I am a patient, I have a doctor have consulted me, then I need to do the order. Like I have some paper on my hand, there are multiple pharmacy in the doctor area, that we need to choose the which pharmacy giving us proper discount, proper medicines they are providing, that we need to just check that. Like a pharmacy, if I am logging, that I can see that how many orders I have, completed order, accepted order. If there is any pending order, then I can see that, I can check that how many medicines available with me. I will accept that order and add the bill and accept that order. Same time, the patient will get the notification that this pharmacy have accepted your order, and this time you will get your order to be delivered. It would be offline. Payment and delivered things are offline, right? Here also you can see that there are color code left side. You can see that it's not just for the display purpose. It's there is some logic behind that. That initially you have the order for the first time, it would be some first time you will be green color, second order you will be like purple color, then third same order here you will yellow color, and continue you are ordering with the same prescription, you will get so you can see that's orange color, that this is our primary customer and they are ordering with the same prescription. So they require to keep their medicines in their shop, pharmacy, right? Doctors. Here, this is not like all the database doctors would be display. Here data would be display only those doctor which consultation of the patient have order to this pharmacy. Like I am a patient, I have consultation with care of Shah doctor, then I have order with any ABC pharmacy, then only ABC pharmacy can see the doctors, right? They can coordinate with that doctor, like these medicines are not available, sir, what, which other medicine we should update over there. That same doctor can apply them, like ABC medicine not available, you can use same medicine with the same company with the XYZ medicine. Same time, pharmacy will coordinate with patient and get the approval, then place the order for them. right? Then we have some, you know, inventory. This is the inventory. These are, there is a multi over 40 to 50,000 medicines are available. So can see the any medicine. This is the medicine is not available with me, that I can check this. So, you know, demo server we have updated. That's why it's coming. Discounted medicine, you can see that medicines. So we have some reviews, profile schemes. I can add the scheme. What is the scheme we have on, like on the August 15th, we can have 50% off on the all the medicines. And these are the basic things we have, like we have overview of like medicines, like doctor, patient and pharmacy. These all are connected with virtual, connected with each other, and you know, they can use the technology. Now upcoming will be the video calling functionality, audio calling functionality, messaging functionality will be, we have for the doctor, patient and pharmacy. So they don't require to visit the, you know, consultation to the their clinic location. They can do that with online. So these are the application area. So Shashank, hello.
Yes.
Yeah, Shashank.
Yeah, please get back to presentation.
Yeah.
So now we will move to admin panel. Yeah, admin section. Yeah, prior to that, thank you Akash and thank you Trishal bhai, like, for a wonderful demo. So for admin part, like we have admin modules, like, you know, patient management, then symptoms management, like where admin will add all the symptoms from backend, which will be accessible to the doctor and patient also. Also, whatever prescription will be there, e-prescriptions will be there, it will be accessible by administrator. Administrator can have view access to those consultations. Also, user reviews, whatever user reviews are there for doctors, patient or pharmacy. So administrator have access, they can view these user reviews. Also, like doctor management, patient management, pharmacy management. So basic user management model is there. Then doctor specialization management, like whatever specialization, MBBS, BDS, anything. So such specializations are managed by admin. Then, as I mentioned earlier, so like, you know, medicine inventory is there, sort of thousands of medicines from where, like, you know, pharmacies, doctor and patient can access those medicine list. Also, orders management, whatever orders are flowing through this application. So these are accessible, or these will be visible to the admin. Here, all the orders are delivered offline. Like once you place order, order will be accepted or rejected. And once acceptance of order, that order delivery will be offline. Payment also will be offline. We don't have any payment gateway integration. Also, like if there are any reviews and if any abusive reviews are there, so patient can report that particular user. So admin can view those user reports to take appropriate actions. We have roles and permissions. So like admin can create different sub-admin roles, and they can provide some limited access. Like for example, I want to create one user role which will have access to only patient management or only pending patient profiles, like whatever pending list of patients. So I can view those patient list and I can take appropriate actions. So we have such kind of roles and permission management. And again, of course, like CMS pages are there, like about privacy policy. So such kind of pages are managed through the CMS management. Next slide, please. So these are some screenshots from admin panel, like dashboard, where you will see indicators like total patients, doctors, total pharmacies, then total orders, total consultation on this particular platform, and then total medical documents, which are uploaded by patient. Okay. Then second screen, you will see like patient management, where you will see listing of patients, and from where, like, you know, admin will have access to patient profile, and patient, admin can take appropriate action, enable or disable that particular patient. Then doctors management is there, where admin can view doctor's profile, also KYC document, whatever KYC doctors have provided, and based on that, they can admin can enable or disable access to the doctor. Fourth one is like orders management, like whatever orders are there, like whatever orders are flowing from the patient to the pharmacy. So all the orders will be visible to the admin. Next slide. Yes. So medicine inventory management, like, you know, here we can add medicine based on category. And right now we have categories like A to Z, like alphabetical order we have maintained. Next approach is like, you know, client is going to categorize based on disease also or symptoms also. But right now we have alphabetical order. So based on alphabetical order, you can add medicines. Then specialization management, like, you know, to add, we have added some, so at the time of doctor registration, they can select their specialization from the drop-down list. Symptoms management, here also we have added a few thousands of symptoms. So it will help patient and doctors also, like whenever doctor is prescribing any prescription, so they can simply search any symptoms and they can add to that particular prescription. Then a fourth one is like user reviews, whatever user has provided review for another user, like be it patient or pharmacy or doctor. So admin can have access to that particular user reviews, like when it was created and what was rating and reviews there. Next slide, please. We are maintaining locations also. So like city, we have provided city management. So based on that, like admin will get analytical data, like, you know, from which city, how many users are registered there, or from which city, how many orders are coming there on platform. Also reports management, like if there is any abusive review or inappropriate review, so user can simply report those particular user, and admin will get a list of those particular user lists, like who have reported for any specific user with proper reason, like why he or she wants to report that particular user. And again, as I mentioned, like, you know, we have roles and permission and sub-admin management. So from where we can manage roles and permission and assign it to the different user roles. Yeah, next slide, please. Yes. So now we are going to discuss about our team members who contribute for this particular application. Without their efforts, it was not possible. So I would like to thank him for his efforts. Like he is really phenomenal, like through the entire journey. He did a fantastic job. Just like, you know, he was ready to accept any challenge. He was ready to solve client query also anytime. So it's really wonderful efforts right now also, like, you know, like we are in journey of, like, you know, uploading to the App Store or Play Store. So during that journey also, Tushar bhai is doing fantastic job, and he's like client is pretty much happy with him. So I would like to thank him a lot, like, for his efforts. Then we have a web admin technical lead, Rahul Trivedi. Like then from iOS application, iOS side, like Nipul Daki and Umesh Sharma. Then from Android, Akash and Akash Morodia. From web admin, like Harsha Prajapati and her team member. Then from API side, Jaspal Prajapati. From designs, like whatever neat and clean designs you saw on this application. So it was designed by Atul Thakur. Then QA has been done from Rohit. So, These are some technical team members like who involved in actual development of this particular application. Now I'm coming to the business development. Like, it's a very tough task. Like, and Meloni did a fantastic job. Like, you know, when we are talking about negotiate, it's a special art. Okay, negotiating from the cost. Like, because we are technical team members, we don't bother about costing and all the things. But while negotiating with the client, it's really a skillful thing. And Meloni did really nice job, and she has handled this particular client properly, and tried to get like CRs also. Like right now also we had a wonderful CRs. So it's a really wonderful job done by Meloni. Special thanks to her. From business analyst point of view, Avinash contributed a lot for requirement understanding and document. I'd like to give a special thanks to the Maharshi and Hiren for their continuous support. So, like, due to their support only, we complete this particular application. Yeah, next slide, please. So this all about like whatever we have developed so far, and now we have phase two. Like, you know, right now status is like we have got approval from the App Store, and we have pending approval from the Google Play Store. So once we receive, also so client is planning to go live. Like it might be next week only. Okay, so next once this application will be go live, then we will have phase two for this. Next slide, please. Next slide. Yeah, so advertisement management. Right now this application is not having any advertisement, but client is planning to have advertisement in this particular application. And also Mirrorfly integration for real-time video call, audio call, and messaging purpose. So this is all about Medify healthcare application. Thank you for listening us. If you have any queries, please feel free to ask. Thank you.
Yeah, hello all team members. If you have any query, then please ask. Otherwise, we can move to our next quick project for the helper. First. Hello. Looks everyone is muted.
Rushal sir, no queries. Let's move ahead.
Yeah, great. Thanks. So next project is my help us that I will quickly give you some idea about that. Yeah, everyone can see this. This is the Health First application. This is about pharmacy products. This is the UAE based application that delivers the all types of category products like baby, beauty, healthcare application, personal application, OTC, and prescription application. Like we have seen in the Medify that user upload the prescription, and based on that customer get patient get their order to be delivered. In same application we have option that customer or patient, anyone can upload their prescription. Admin will review that prescription and they will order on behalf of the customer. Here in this application we have good thought, like it's a very speed application that user whatever you have searched, you can get that details in the same time. Like I can see that this is the category we have. I can see all the view all products in the same time. It's within the 1 or 2 seconds we are getting all the data from the server. There is a more than around 10 to 15,000 records are there, maybe more than that. So after live, I don't know how much they have uploaded, but we can have multiple like things like that. We have used UI design like that. And so in this is a basic e-commerce application from healthcare related, where a customer can order their product, whatever product they want. They can order the product with cash on delivery. They have option like pick up from store, cash on delivery, and order with pay for, like your cards and whatever you prefer. So this is the best application I have ever. We have category, subcategory, and their products. whatever products we have, it should be a display over here. You can see that whatever product we have, it's the same within the same time, it's a display. You can search the product with your tags, your speech, and your whatever you search with that, it will immediately start searching. So you have just a paper on your hand, you can search with that. Whatever research you had done in past, also it's keep in their search list. Like this is, you know, custom search, like you have searched previously these products from last 10 days, you have searched these products, whatever products you search, then you will get the result. See, you can see the related products over there. You can see that search tags, these are the related products are available, products with the images, these things you can add. You can add with your wish list. You can reorder the thing same time. You can keep in your wish list. You can share the product. We have save time. You are, and these are the all the categories and everything are updated with every cron run from the client server to our Magento server and update the quantity of their records. And we have same time, just I have ordered the things. Same time, we have pharmacy which is nearby me. I can select that pharmacy that I will go there and pick up the things and use there, access the things. You know, pick up from store, I will get all the store nearby me. With the geolocation, whatever stores are nearby me, I can select them and place the order. Right? Yeah. This was alert that this product is not available in this store. That is the checking the things. It was there for that alert, right? So whatever order we have done, like dosage reminder, we have dosage reminder application. Like I need to take medicines daily morning, noon and evening, this medicine. And so I have add this medicine in my add reminder that I need to take a medicine daily morning, evening, and I'm adding the time. Same time, this will notify me that this is the time you need to take your medicine. You need to take this a medicine. I can edit, delete, inactive. Once 10 days are completed, then I can inactive my medicine. Same time, I can upload my prescription, whatever prescription I need to order, I can add them prescriptions from here, right? I can attach the prescription, whatever prescription I need to add, that I can do that. Same, if I am a customer, I have ordered the for the ABC product to XYZ pharmacy, same pharmacy have their delivery boy who can access the application. They get their orders same time and they can check their how many pending orders for the 2 day. These are the orders. They can check that this is the order, this is the address. Same time if the order is in a pending status, then they need to pick up that order. Then they pick up the order, then deliver the order, and they need to take their who had taken the order, their mobile number, and they want to take some, you know, approval. That person is not available nearby home, person is taking, then take their address proof details like Aadhaar card, PAN card, whatever they want to do. So these are the basic e-commerce overview of this application, Health First, we have right now on our hand. This is a very big application. It's hard to explain you within a few minutes, but I'm trying to cover the things in as early as. This is the based on the product category, order, cart, checkout process, get the order to the pharmacy, pick up the store, and order in their device. They will get the notification as a pharmacy assign them the order. Same time they can pick up the order from their store and deliver to the customer. This is the basic business flow of this Health First application, and this is very helpful to us. We have used Webcool source code and it's very helpful to us. Now upcoming projects, you know, these are the things are very helpful. We had given demonstration to the many clients with this application, and I'm sure our, you know, we'll continue such a kind of projects in upcoming days. So thank you guys. This is Trushal. And if you have any query, you can ask me.
Okay. Trushal sir, what was the most challenging part into this Planet First?
Planet First most challenging part is the product landing that we have worked very hard in that. You can see that it's loading within 1 or 2 seconds. There is no required time. You can see that it's loading the with images, everything within 1 or 2 seconds. This is the live application.
What kind of a technology that you have used so to make this?
So in the Magento side, we have they are clearing the cache in every manner and get the data with same way, same record. They have some background. They have cleared the image sizes like this image is going to be up to maybe 2 or 3 KBs only. They resize the thing. They had used some extensions to resize the image and clone the things. You know, whatever you have searched partially, it will be in their cache system, and we are getting the data with that.
Anything into a mobile part that we have did to make this happen? Any specific
mobile
thing?
Mobile parts, it's see, this is not default table we have, sir, but we are getting quickly response from the API side. So it's load the things and lazy loading functionality.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Perfect, guys. Thank you. Team, any questions? Ramesh, any questions from you?
No, sir.
Okay. Krimi, you had any question?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Good morning. So I just wanted to know, like, how much time efforts did this Health First application and Medify took?
Yeah, Medify have took initially, I think, 2 to 3 months. And the Health First was first challenge for us that we are, you know, getting some third-party code to integrate the things, and there are multiple changes are coming from the client side. We are not, compatible with the third-party code. We have just customized many things to get the things done. Now we have, you know, a very good product in our hand that we can manage the things with coordinating with Magento and mobile side, iOS, Android, Delivery Boy application with the quickly. Like, you know, you have some banners, we have some category, you have some brands, you have some feature products, you have some offers, whatever you have, we are just loading the categories in this within the 1 second. We are loading the products within the some time. We are ordering the product with and get the things done. We have option to pick up the store, nearest store would be display. These are the, you know, big challenges for us to get the things.
Yeah. And in Medify application, like I had the concern, like, do you have a inventory count? Like I saw the green and red check availability status buttons, like indicators, but there was no inventory count. So
it's not like, you know, selling the things. They are not selling the things. They are just providing that these are the products available with me and these are the not available. So okay. If you have added in your not available thing, then green button would be red button.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, customer can, patient can order the things, but if it's not available, then the pharmacy can coordinate with them by calling the things and chat the things.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you.
Yep.
Hitesh, any question from you?
No, sir.
Hello. Trushal, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You know, sir, I'm waiting for you.
In a nowadays, the popular applications that we see like Swiggy and Zomato, when a delivery boy calls the actual customer, its number gets masked. Okay. And similarly, when a customer calls the restaurant or delivery boy, it's action. Thus, by protecting the privacy on both the sides. So, is there any provision that we have made in Medify and this Health First applications?
No, sir. We haven't made. This is the totally open that delivery boy can call the customer, and same time customer can see their location. And there is a call us button where they have made their, you know, call center like that, and they are managing the with their number. There is one, you know, open number with them. So as you can order, yeah, you can see that with the order, you have some query, you can have some call us number.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Yes, anyone?
Okay, I guess we are sorted. Thank you so much, Trushal sir. Thank you so much, Shashank, to provide such an interesting demo. Hopefully, like, everybody got some ideas about what we did, how we did, and other details. Thank you so much, guys, team, for joining this session. Keep us posted if you have any suggestion for next set of sessions out there. Have a happy weekend. Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you, sir.